I came from the mud. There's dirt on my hands. Strong like a tree. There's roots where I stand. Oh, I've been running from the law. Hope they won't shoot me down soon.
Hello mga motorista and welcome to another episode of Motorista Adventures. Today we are here at Toyota Cagayan de Oro. And for this video, we have here the Toyota Hilux top of the line GR Sport nila. And i-compare natin yan no, dun sa ating Toyota Hilux Conquest 4x4. Now, these two are very similar when it comes to their drivetrain. Pero titignan natin kung ano yung mga spec and feature differences nila para malaman natin kung worth it ba talaga yung top of the line model in comparison to the Conquest model. If you're interested in this video, tara samahan niyo mga motorista, simulan na natin. So simulan natin mga motorista yung video dito sa ating lower model. Now this is the Hilux Conquest 4x4 2.8 liter. And yung color na to is oxide bronze metallic and it is really, really nice color. No? Hindi siya dumihin kasi brown na nga siya yung color niya. And of course, meron siyang mga flaking sa kanyang paint. Sa harap natin, dito sa ating Conquest, we can see na you still have this really nice looking LED headlights. Everything is LED for this model year of the Hilux. No? And the 2022 models, no? LED headlights, LED daytime running lights, and napakaliwanag nito. Yung turn signal lights natin, maliwanag din siya na signal light LED din. Now, for the front part of this Hilux Conquest, kita natin na meron tayong front parking sensors. Ito yung sensors niya. And then, yung fog lights natin is also LED, projector type siya na design. And then, sa ilalim na part naman, kita natin na meron tayong bash plate dyan. And also, you have your Toyota logo, pati na din yung front camera natin dun sa ilalim ng logo. And for this model year, meron tayong radar sensors sa ating mga Hilux, especially for the Conquest models. The logo is underneath a glass. Parang ganun siya. Nandun yung radar sensors natin. Yung grill natin, no, napakasimple lang, straightforward yung grill natin. Walang design or anything like that. You can see na you have a intercooler sa harap and then sa likod naman yung condenser niya. Sa pinakalikod yung radiator natin. Moving on to the side, for the Conquest model, meron tayong mga body claddings, no, na extension here. Ayan, meron siyang mga rubber dito, inserts. And then, kita nyo din na yung ating mga wheels and tires, 18 inches, no, 18 inches. So, yung wheels na to is parang, ano siya, gunmetal finish siya na wheels, no, block with a little bit of a brownish gray na finish sa harapan na part. So, yung tires natin is road bias, hindi siya yung parang pang off-road talaga, so, dweller highway terrain. So kung i-offroad mo si Hilux, I think these are the first ones that you need to upgrade. Sa atin namang suspension setup, standard suspension lang, double wishbone suspension, nothing special there. Mamaya titignan natin sa Conquest kung ano yung difference nila when it comes to the suspension part. Wala tayong masyadong sound deadening material here sa ating Hilux na Conquest model. Moving on to the side, you have your step board, meron tayong Hilux na badging, meron tayong paddle lamps, camera on the side mirror, and then LED turn signal light repeaters, and meron tayong matte na finish sa ating side mirrors. So specific yan sa mga Conquest models natin. You have a ano ornament dito na parang roof rail, meron siyang smart entry feature. Dito sa likuran na part, napakalaki ng ating sports bar, meron tayong Conquest na sticker, and leaf spring suspension pa din tayo as with the current Hilux models. And then also, yan, this is a more clear view sa kanyang rims, no? Parang all black nga siya mga motorista tignan here, which is really nice, no? Very modern tignan. Okay, so moving on to the back, we can see na it is a typical Hilux Conquest na likuran. So meron tayong plastic finish here, which houses your third brake light, Hilux na badge, reverse camera, apat na sensor sa ilalim, and meron tayong LED, no? Sa ating tail lights, LED brake lights. And also, we have bulb type na turn signal lights. Meron din siyang tailgate assist, si Conquest. Alright, so magaan lang siya. Kasama na yung bed liner natin for the price. And cargo hooks. So ayan yung exterior features natin sa ating Conquest. take a look at the conquest naman mga motorista, no, para makumpara talaga natin kung ano yung differences nila. But there are some noticeable differences sa kanyang dalawa, especially sa harapan na part. Yung grill ng conquest natin is a more simpler grill, no, pa straight-straight lang yon. Ito naman is honeycomb siya na design. And then you have your Toyota logo dito or Toyota name na naka-spell out talaga. Kita nyo din na meron tayong front camera and wala na tayong Toyota na logo, no. Ito na lang yung ating radar sensors here, no. Different siya. Itong GR Sport natin is black and meron din siyang flaking mga motorista, no. And if you take a look at the headlights, basically the headlights are exactly the same as with the Conquest. Pati din yung sides natin, instead of the matte parts, it is replaced by glossy materials, no. So ayan, glossy na to. Meron siyang ano dito mga motorista, no, different yung lower bumper natin na design. Meron siyang parang housing here. So kita nyo, meron tayong LED fog lights din. Parehas lang to sa ating Conquest na ano na mga sides, no, except that this is body colored, no, and glossy. Right. So what else can we see? Meron pa din tayong badge plate sa ilalim, of course. Meron tayong GR badge pala dito, which is not on the Conquest model. Yeah, projector, no, bi-beam LED silang dalawa. Dito naman sa ating wheels. Okay, so dito tayo sa ano, sa likuran na part, no. So sobrang putik dito. But ito yung wheels natin, it's a more special type of wheel pero 18-inch pa rin, parehas lang sila ng gulong ni Hilux Conquest. But if I were to choose, no, I really like this rims, no. This definite upgrade from the standard wheels, from the common na Conquest natin. So mas maliit lang kasi yung mga GRS na roaming around dito sa atin in comparison to the Conquest na very common. So again, this will feel special. Another thing that's special sa ating Toyota Hilux GRS is yung suspension natin. It's a different suspension setup, no. It's a different shock absorber. So instead of the standard shock absorber, ito naka monotube siya. It is a little bit more sporty than the standard Hilux Conquest. So although when it comes to the ride comfort, I think they are quite similar pa rin. But this is a more performance based na suspension setup. So dito sa ating Hilux na GRS, meron tayong blind spot monitoring. Dun sa ating Hilux Conquest na 2.8 4x4, wala tayong blind spot monitoring. That's quite a difference when it comes to their safety feature. Now aside sa ating blind spot monitoring, moving on to the back, parehas lang sila ng mga sports bar, definitely the same, but wala na tayong ornament dito na parang roof rail. And moving on to the back, definitely mas simpler siya na design, meron tayong GR Sport na kalagay. Sa ilalim naman, all glossy black finishes and then apat na sensors pa din tayo. We still have your LED brake lights, LED park light. Simpler siya yung design dito sa ating tailgate mga motorista. Meron tayong Toyota logo dito, Hilux and GR Sport badge. So, if you take a look at here, no, kasama pa din yung ating bed liner pero wala tayong mga aux outlet like the Ford Ranger dito sa likuran. So yung shock naman dito sa likod is yung difference nilang dalawa. Alright? Sport na siya na setup, no, than the Conquest model. To conclude it, mga motorista, yung exterior features natin. All in all, if you want the more exclusive look siya na Hilux and then hindi siya ganun kadami on the road, like you can definitely tell a GRS from a standard Conquest model because of the front, no, yung Toyota na naming dyan, and then also yung rims natin is different and the finish itself is a little bit more sophisticated now when it comes to the sides kasi glossy siya lahat. So next natin is pag-usapan natin yung drivetrain nilang dalawa and the engine itself. Si Toyota Hilux Conquest and GRS get similar engine options. This is the bigger displacement 2.8 liter 4-cylinder direct injected variable nozzle turbo ni Toyota mga motorista. This is the 1GD FTV na very familiar na sa atin from the previous Toyota Hilux na pre-updated models. So this engine makes 204 PS of peak power and then yung torque natin is a good 500 Nm of torque at par yan sa ating Ford Ranger, Wildtrak and Raptor, no. Let's take a closer look. So dito sa taas na part, meron tayong mga sound insulation or sound deadening material, pati din dun sa likuran na part. And malaki yung airbox natin for this model year. One thing na different sa Hilux and Rangers natin, no, is si Ranger meron siyang intake dito. Ito lang siya, is standard airbox siya. Ito din yung ating battery. This battery is FB yung gamit nila. And yeah, overall very tight yung space, no, in terms of length paharap dito sa ating Hilux, no, in engine bay wise. So ating kasamang hood struts na, ito yung ating turbocharger. And yeah, that's about it dito sa harapan ng Toyota Hilux Conquest. Power steering natin is still hydraulic, hindi siya electric powered, so medyo may kabigatan siya pag naka-standstill at iniikot mo yung steering wheel. Now, both of them get 6-speed automatic transmission. Sa Conquest model, you have an option for manual na 4x4, pero sa GRS, automatic lang talaga. And then both of them gets limited slip differential. Meron din silang locking rear differential. Same lang silang dalawa. So very similar silang dalawa when it comes to drivetrain. Tell me I'm the one you want. Tell me I'm the reason. Your heart beats and it won't stop. I wanna be the feeling you've been after all your life. Baby, is it too much to ask for a love just like that? Sa pasok tayo sa loob. And let's start first dito sa ating mga door panels, no. So, very similar sila sa GRS natin. Plastic materials here. May ating brush finish dito. Leather yung ating armrest with white stitching. You have your speaker grill dito sa ilalim. And then, automatic everything for the windows, which is really nice. You have here your speaker grill or tweeter natin. And also, it is power folding yung ating side mirrors. Lock and lock buttons are here. Gloss finish yung ating part na to. Now, one disadvantage of the Toyota Hilux Conquest in comparison to the Hilux GRS is the seats. No, these are very standard seats nowadays. No, hindi siya leather. Design itself is pretty standard. Kita nyo naman, you have recline, height, and slide. No, pretty standard stuff. Kita nyo din on the side, no, you have your buttons for your park sensors button on and off, and then view natin for our 360 camera system. So one thing that I really like about manual seats is mabilis mo lang siyang i-adjust. So from the previous video, alam nyo na na this interior is getting a little bit dated, but material quality is still very good. So yung materials in terms of the plastics is high quality, no, hindi siya yung low quality na mga plastics naman. And if you take a look at the glove compartment, meron tayong upper and lower and lockable plus damp siya. Merong air conditioning din dun sa ating passenger compartment sa taas. So, dito naman, you have your 8-inch display, CarPlay, Android Auto. Resolution niya is not that high quality in comparison to the Ford Ranger and also Nissan Navara's infotainment systems. Now, engine push to start natin right here. For the steering wheel naman, we have here leather steering wheel, good chunky steering wheel, Toyota logo dito. You have your controls here for your volume and the infotainment system, pati voice command natin. Dito naman sa side, you have your controls for the screen doon sa harap. And speaking of the screen, next generation Hilux, hopefully mas malaki na yung screen natin to make it very competitive with the other brands. So, this screen is a 4.2-inch display. Analog pa din yung gauges natin. But it does provide a lot of information when it comes to your advanced driver aids. Speaking of driver aids, si Hilux meron siyang lane departure alert. And then pre-collision system and then radar cruise control. Meron din tayong switch dito for the cruise control itself. Ito yung page button natin. Okay, hazard button, yung digital clock natin nasa taas ng part. Auto dimming rear view mirror na din si Hilux Conquest. And then you have your black headliner here. And then dome lights natin is still incandescent. Right, and then dito naman kita natin yung ating, kita natin yung ating sunglass holder. So wala tayong vanity mirror. Sa kabila meron, pero wala siyang ilaw. Yeah. Right, so dito naman sa ilalim na part, dual zone climate control na tayo. Ilalim na part, mga motorista, you can see your traction control button off. Meron din tayong locking rear differential, downhill assist control, or hill descent control yet. Dalawang cup holders, nalagyan sa mga things mo dito. And then your 6-speed automatic transmission shifter, plus minus. Wala tayong paddle shifter. Mamaya tignan natin sa Conquest kung meron yung paddle shifter. Eco and power mode. So this basically adjusts your throttle sensitivity. So kung power mode, mas mabilis yung response ng throttle than in eco mode. So yung handbrake natin is still standard. Hindi pa siya electronic parking brake. Yung ating armrest is leather here. Okay? So basically yung mga leather parts dito sa ating Conquest is the this one, yung ating armrest dun sa mga sides is all leather, but the seats is not leather, no, yun lang. Now for the Conquest models, no, especially for the 4x4, you have 7 airbags dito sa loob. Unlike sa mga 4x2 na Conquest model with a smaller engine, you only get 3 airbags. Meron din tayong 360 degree camera for the Hilux Conquest, and as you can see, definition should be improved, but it's a 360 camera, mas easy mong i-park si Hilux. Okay, so dito sa likod naman ni Hilux Conquest. So, meron tayong mga things here like 4 kilogram hooks. Ayan, kita nyo yung ating mga pockets dito. And then, maliit lang yung hump natin. Very livable naman siya. You have your armrest with cup holders. Okay, and wala tayong air vents. Okay, so what's different dito sa GRS natin is basically this part. No? Instead of that brush finish siya, ito is parang sprayed lang siya na finish here. And then glossy yung ating door handles, leather pa din dito, but instead of that white leather sa Conquest, this is a more sporty red leather stitching. Yan, you have your cup holders, speaker grill, yung ating tweeter, parehas lang sila. Now once you go up to the GRS, instead of manual seats, you get electric powered seats. So, slide, height, recline, wala siyang lumbar support. So, 8-way adjustable lang siya. And looking at the sides, no, parehas lang sila na meron siyang pop-out cup holders. And then here, meron lang tayong nadagdag dito na button. No, meron na to sa ating Conquest, yung dalawang to. Yung nadagdag is blind spot monitoring natin na button. Obviously, you can turn it on or off if you want. So, yung latches natin. So, yung ating pedals din is more sporty. For the steering wheel ni Conquest, kita nyo meron siyang red stripe here like the Ranger Raptor. And then the red stitching, mas maganda yung stitching nito of course. And then meron tayong GR na badge here. And slightly different finish dito sa ilalim na part. So ngayon naman, pasok tayo sa ating Conquest. So dito sa loob ni Conquest, mga motorista, no, ito yung seats natin. So this is a big upgrade from the Hilux Conquest, no. Since cloth seats lang yun, these seats are looking really nice. Especially, meron siyang GR na badge dito. You have leather on the sides. Dito din, sa side natin. And then, dito sa ilalim na part, it is a suede material and perforated siya. Another upgrade sa ating steering wheel is ngayon naman, meron na siyang paddle shifters, unlike before. And yung steering wheel natin, sporty steering wheel siya. When it comes to the gauges, no, definitely different din siya sa ating Hilux na Conquest, no. It's a more simpler design and a little bit more sporty. And yung ating mga finish dito is meron siyang glossy finish, and then but of course nothing too different naman sa ating Conquest. Yung ating engine push to start button din dito is more special because it has a GR badge. But infotainment wise, parehas lang sila. Both of them gets the data connection, no? So you can check the Hilux and the GR Sport kung asan sila in the parking lot and kung ano yung mga last fuel consumption mo. You can see that on Toyota Connect app. So dito sa ilalim na part, definitely parehas lang to sa ating Conquest. And you still have your part-time four-wheel drive na knob here. Hindi ko na i-explain lahat kasi definitely parehas lang talaga sila. So pati din dito, parehas lang. Shifter natin, nothing special, parehas lang talaga sila. Meron din tayong eco and power modes, and yung ating handbrake, yung armrest natin, leather siya pero yung stitching niya is red. Same lang din. Okay, sa taas, auto-dimming pa rin yung rear view mirror natin, and incandescent pa rin yung ating mga dome lights. So that's basically it for the GRS, mga motorista, no? There are some nice add-ons for the interior. Big one is the seats itself. No? It's a more luxurious seat than the Conquest. And also, these paddle shifters is also a really good addition. Meron tayong buttons again. Blind spot monitoring. Meron pa din tayong lane departure alert. And then also pre-collision system. Nothing different talaga. And then, you have your cruise control button dito. This is the back seats of our GR Sport. And kita nyo naman, pati din dito, no, mix of leather and suede material. So, very, very premium looking. But the things that are inside dito, mostly parehas lang sa ating Conquest. Like the 4kg hooks, pockets here. And one addition that we like, no, na hinahanap talaga natin sa mga Hilux is rear air vents, which is only found for the top of the line model, unfortunately. So, wala na to sa ating Conquest 4x4, no? So, if you're expecting rear air vents for the Conquest, sorry, but wala siya doon. And then, mostly black yung interior dito, of course, basically the same then. And then, yung ating stitching lang dito is red, no? Instead of the white stitching. Right? So, split type din yung ating mga seats. So, you can fold this up. Meron siyang ISOFIX anchor points. And you have your rear defoggers. And also, 7 airbags pa din sa ating Conquest. 7 airbags pa din, same sa ating Conquest, yung GRS. But when you sit here, no, mas malamig yung passenger talaga dito because of these rear air vents. So, yung ating Hilux Conquest is currently priced, no, for the 4x4 automatic variant, 1,957,000. Ito namang Hilux GRS natin with all the features and things na pwede na lang ilagay sa isang Hilux is priced at 2,077,000 pesos, mga motorista, no. Kung ikukumpara natin yung mga SRP nilang dalawa, 120,000 lang yung difference nila. For 120,000, you get better seats, you get electronic seats, you have blind spot monitoring, we have rear cross traffic alert. Kasama din dyan yung ating mga rims na mas sophisticated looking than the Conquest now. What do you think? 120,000 pesos, is it worth it? Let me know down sa ating comments, mga motorista, if you find it worth it na to upgrade na lang sa top of the line GRS models than go for the 4x4 Conquest model. But for, I think, no, in my opinion, for most people na bumibili ng Hilux, they always prefer the Conquest models. You have lots of options sa kanilang lineup from 4x4, 4x2, smaller engine, and also meron din silang options for manual transmission. No? So, one big advantage yan for the Conquest model. Standalone si GRS, mga motorista. No? So, that's what you have to know. So, this is a more of the special product nila. Put everything, no, in terms of creature comforts dito sa ating GRS. So if you like this video, mga motorista, hit the thumbs up, subscribe, click that notification bell for more videos in this channel. Once again, this is Adrian, you are watching Motorista Adventures, and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.